Dear students, so today we are going to discuss about students with sensory disabilities. So the objectives of this particular unit is to identify the various types of sensory disabilities. Secondly, to discuss how to assess the performance of the various types of students with sensory disability. Third, to describe the needs of the students with respect to their learning characteristics. And lastly, to explain the specific strategies to meet their needs in the schools. So now, coming to the introduction, we will be able to understand what you mean or exactly what is the definition of sensory disability. So, as we know about, we have various senses. So, when the senses such as sight, hearing, smell, touch, taste, and spatial awareness of a person is impaired, then he or she may be called a person with sensory disability or sensory impairment. The term sensory impairment is mainly used to refer to the people or the persons with either hearing impairment or visual impairment, or both hearing impairment and visual impairment. The extent of which may vary from various person to person. A person need not to have full loss of senses to be sensory impaired. Sensory impairment encompasses hearing loss, including whole range, visual loss, including blindness and partial sight, and multisensory impairment. So now, what do you mean by multisensory impairment? So multisensory impairment means having diagnosed visual and hearing impairment with at least mild loss in each modality or depth learning. Students suffering from these types of disabilities are called students with sensory disabilities. Now coming to the classification, how the students with visual impairment and low vision can be classified. So it can be classified into three categories like mild, moderate and severe. What do you mean by mild? Mild is where the students with visual impairment and low vision can read relatively large characters. The students with visual impairment and low vision have no difficulty in identifying shapes, color and brightness. Coming to the moderate, students with visual impairment and low vision can tell various shapes and colors of objects and can distinguish between brightness and darkness. The students with visual impairment and low vision can only read characters with larger size and broader stroke. Coming to the severe classification, students with visual impairment and low vision can only distinguish more obvious changes in related with to brightness and darkness. Students with visual impairment and low vision may not see anything or can be told as completely blind. Now coming to the needs of learners with visual impairment and low vision. So learners with visual impairment and have unique educational needs. To fulfill the needs, learners require specialized services. Like books and materials require specialized services, like books and materials in appropriate media, which includes braille, as well as specialized various equipment are present, and technology to assure equal. Specialized curricula is also required to enable them to most effectively compete with their peer groups, or peers we can say in school, ultimately in the society. There are some educational needs for a visual impairment if the learners have any type of their problem. If the learners have vision loss, his or her all-round development may be disturbed. Therefore, at first, it is very much essential to give proper attention. Secondly, select and use of the appropriate learning medium is very much essential, and it's a very important task of a teacher to identify the students or their needs of learners, especially with visual impairment and low. Thirdly, prepare plan programs for training in reading and writing. Fourthly, carefully handle the appropriate assistive devices. And lastly, acquire the techniques of orientation and mobility training. Now, coming to the assessments of students with visual impairment and low vision. Assessing the learner's strength and weakness is one of the most important prerequisites in planning a learner's educational program. So, following we can see are some of the main three areas of assessment. So, the first one is assistive technology assessment. Second is functional vision assessment. And third is learning media. So, what do you mean by, or what is functional vision assessment? A variety of evaluation techniques which test the child's use of vision and visual efficiency in daily activities are called functional vision assessment. The assessment is made over a number of sessions to determine how the child accesses his or her visual environment, such as what is the distance to be maintained from the chalkboard, or what print size she or he is able to see. Contribution from the child's orientation and mobility instructor is helpful. A certified teacher of the students with visual impairment also needs this assessment. So that's all in this particular video. Thank you.